From Del Mar up to Seaford, up to Bridgeville. Looking good to go as we travel along on 113 and Route 1 shaping up. Good in Worcester County, or 50 and 92 in from Ocean City, 589 through Ocean Pines, good. 113, good from Bishopville to Berlin to Newark, Snow Hill, and Pocomoke. And in Waccamaco County, steady going 50 from Willards to Pittsfield to Parsonsburg. Bypass around Salisbury looking good, and 50 good out to the Bay Bridge. That's your traffic for The Voice Radio Network.
Forrest Galante.
Good morning, guys.
Hey.
Hi, Forrest.
Good morning. It's Bill and Jessica, Power 1017. How are you?
Very well, thank you. Happy to be on.
Yes, absolutely, man. Well, look, Shark Week, cannot believe it's already here. End of July. Kicking off on Discovery Plus. Give us a rundown, man. Talk to us about it. You got two shows, one repeat from last year. The second's a brand new show. But talk to us a little bit about Shark Week, what it means to you, and, you know, what you're going to be doing, because it's exciting.
Of course, yeah, guys. It's Shark Week. It's the most wonderful week of the year, an entire week dedicated to sharing and promoting these wonderful and magnificent ancient creatures that have been on our planet for longer than trees. So I'm very fortunate. I have two specials this year. Jaws of Alaska, which aired on Discovery Plus last year and is coming to Shark Week for the very first time this year. And then the one I'm really excited about, which is Forrest Galante and the Island of the Walking Shark. And as dramatic as that title is, and we'll get into this in a minute, that is actually a show about sharks that can walk on land.
Right.
What?
Wow. How is that possible? How is that possible?
Gotcha. You're going to have to tune in to find out. No, I'm just kidding. So I'll tell you a little bit about it. So Island of the Walking Shark, there are nine known species of epaulette shark, of walking cat shark, and these are a small 2-foot-long shark, of which three of those species occur in the remote, treacherous, and difficult-to-study nation of Papua New Guinea. And so my team and I, you know, what we do is we focus on animals that are difficult to deal with and places that are hard to get to. We head to Papua New Guinea to study these three species of walking shark. And when I say walking shark, what that means is over millions of years, these animals have evolved the specialized ability to use their pelvic and pectoral fins to move like a salamander and walk along the seafloor. But it's rumored that in Papua New Guinea, these three species may actually use that specialized ability to not just walk along the seafloor, but actually leave the ocean, crawl up onto land, and enter into tide pools to hunt for small fishing cetaceans. So my team and I head to Papua New Guinea to dig into this rumor and see if we can capture video footage of this never-before-seen behavior on film. And it's a very fun show.
Wow, definitely looking forward to it. That'll air on Wednesday. Again, this Wednesday, Island of the Walking Sharks, 8 o'clock, Discovery and Discovery Plus. And then the day before on Tuesday, the one from last year, Extinct or Alive, Jaws of Alaska. That's at 7 o'clock. Tell us about that. If we missed it last year.
Absolutely, yeah. Jaws of Alaska, up in Alaska, in an area not known to have great white sharks, certain marine mammals are turning up just completely mauled with big wounds and cuts and gashes on them, and it's not from orcas. So the question is, what Arctic predator could be performing these killings? And so my team and I head up to Alaska to literally dive beneath the ice and try and figure out who it is that's attacking these marine mammals through a series of tests and investigations. And it is a bone-chilling show because it is just freezing conditions, but also another very fun experience.
Wow. Forrest Galante, live on the hotline right now. You're a wildlife biologist. Also, for people who didn't know, you're host of Discovery's Mysterious Creatures, also Animal Planet's Extinct or Alive. Shark Week coming up this week on Discovery. Now, I want to ask you, because I know like a lot of people are tuning in, listening to this interview, and they want to know some of this stuff. So we live on the East Coast. I don't know if you know, we're in Ocean City, Maryland, Rehoboth Beach, Delaware. Uh-huh. You know, like right on the ocean. And, you know, a lot of people talk about, you know, things in the ocean. We go down to the beach all the time. And, you know, sometimes it's we've had a few instances where, you know, there might be talk about a shark, you know, in the water or whatever. Oh, there was a shark, you know, detected or pinned, you know, off the East Coast or whatever. So, like, for real. Like, we're, you know, when we hear that kind of stuff, should people really be alarmed? Because, you know, there are some people who are like, oh, I'm not going to the beach then. Nope, not going to see me at the beach. Should people be alarmed if they hear about a great white shark being pinned, like, I don't know, 100 miles out or you know.
I'm intrigued by
50
it.
Miles out of off the coast. Like, should be, I mean, like, people always refer back to Jaws and that old gag, you know. I mean, for real, like, what?
If I hear shark at the beach, I'm there. I want to see it.
No, but I mean, really, let's just settle it. Should people be alarmed when they hear that kind of stuff?
People need to be aware. You know, what I don't agree with is being scared of sharks or fearful of sharks. What we need to be is aware of sharks and understand them. And if we can understand them, then we can respect them. If we respect them enough, then we can alter our behavior to minimize the likelihood of a negative human-wildlife encounter. And what I mean by that is making smart choices about swimming, where to swim, when to swim, not going in the ocean at dawn or dusk, not going in near river mouths where the water's murky or with fishermen, not having shiny sequined bathing suits on or taking beer cans or water bottles in the ocean that can crunch and sound like the simulation of fish bones crunching. So just being smart, having a good understanding of these animals, that is the best play.
All right, so hold on a minute. You said about what kind of bathing suit?
Well, I'm guessing you're a big sequined bathing suit kind of guy, real round.
Oh, yes. Yes, I am. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
You say don't
flashy
do that.
Flashy and shiny.
Oh, yeah.
Don't do that. We don't want flashy bathing suits. Nothing too shiny or sparkly because it looks like a flashing bait fish underwater.
How about Speedos? Hey, hold on, Forrest. How about Speedos?
You know, now you're baiting in a whole different kind of shark.
Right, right.
That is definitely going to make the shark go the other way.
Right. So you're basically saying just be smart, be aware. Don't go where a bunch of fishermen are. You know, don't go in there. You know, I don't know, what was the other thing?
Dusk and dawn.
You know, during the day.
Don't swim at dusk and dawn. Yeah, exactly. Don't swim near river mouths where the water's murky and sharks like to hunt. You know, little tips and tricks like that can make a big difference.
If you cut yourself on a shell, get out of the water because of the bloody, right?
Sure.
Yes. Well, look, Forrest, thank you so much for checking in. We appreciate it again. This week is Shark Week. Extinct or Alive, Jaws of Alaska. That airs on Tuesday at 7. That's a repeat from last year. Wednesday is the new show this year, Island of Walking Sharks. 8 o'clock, Discovery Plus on Wednesday. Looking forward to that. Forrest Galante, a lot of fun. Thank you so much for checking in, my man. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Have a great day.
The hottest music continues next.